What are minerals? There are over 3,600 different identified minerals on Earth. Only about 20 of these are considered common. But all minerals share certain characteristics. For a substance to be considered a mineral, it must be naturally occurring, inorganic, crystalline, solid, and have a definite chemical composition. But what is the difference between a rock and a mineral? Rocks are naturally occurring aggregates of one or more minerals. Unlike minerals, rocks, such as limestone, can form from organic processes. Rocks such as sandstone can have a wide range of constituent chemicals in their composition. Minerals, like all matter, are composed of atoms. In minerals, these atoms are arranged very precisely and are described as crystalline. As minerals crystallize in the earth, commonly a stray atom becomes incorporated into its crystal structure. These stray atoms, or impurities, can cause profound changes within the mineral. Some minerals, such as quartz, have a range of colors due to these impurities. The impurities that cause a mineral to fluoresce are called activators. For example, pure calcite will not fluoresce. But if a small amount of manganese is incorporated into the calcite crystal, it will glow a bright red. The atoms that compose matter consist of a nucleus and orbiting electrons. When a mineral is exposed to ultraviolet radiation, some of those electrons absorb the energy and become excited. This causes the electron to jump to a higher orbit around the nucleus. This higher orbit is unstable, and the electron eventually has to return to its ground state. This extra energy is released in stages. Some of the energy is released as a small amount of heat. The rest of the energy is released as light. The light energy is emitted with a longer wavelength than the ultraviolet light, and if it is long enough, we will be able to see it as glowing color. This is fluorescence.